Hey guys, so I'm here at school, and I'm probably just a little bit late, but it doesn't matter. It's not opening.
Try the other door.
I can't do it. I got it. Okay. So, is this the class for Fafa?
For Fafa?
Yes.
For FFA?
Yes.
Yes, this is FFA.
What do I do?
Well, take a seat first, and I'll give instructions.
Okay. Just come back here.
Just gonna make yourself comfy on the couch.
I think we're actually doing work, which is, I don't know why, because it's a school. So can I borrow a piece of paper?
No.
I mean, are you even doing anything? Thank you. I need a pencil. Oh, gosh. So this was hands down the worst day of school ever. I hate school, never coming back. So I'm just gonna go home.
What's up, Clearbrook?
I'm Bailey.
And I'm Lawson.
And there's another episode of CBTV.
Let's get it.
A big thanks to Kendra, Angel, Dharma, and Adrian for that last video. They made that in the intro CBTV class in only 5 weeks. We'll have another video from the intro classes next week.
Students, make sure that your clothes are in dress code because the teachers will be knocking down hard on dress code, so watch what you wear.
Here's some highlights from last week's pep rally, football game, and volleyball game.
Need help with classes?
NHS's Project for Awesome will be hosting peer-assisted tutorials on Mondays from 2:30 to 3:30 in room 148, so go check that out.
Hey, B-Skin, are you good at bowling? My man DJ is real good at bowling. Here's a student spotlight to show you.
I've been bowling for 11 years. I was diagnosed with eosinophilic enterocolitis, and my mom didn't want me to always be thinking about my disease after the doctor said I wasn't not make it after too long, and so I found bowling. I practice twice a week, every Thursday and Wednesday. I bowl every other Sunday for the travel league, Monday for the youth scholarship, and Wednesday for high school league. I've gotten the youth state championship twice, the city state, and the ghostly bowling tournament champion. I see in the future for me going to college, then going in the military and bowling for the Army.
I'm DJ Casas, and I'm a bowler.
Oh, I got a streak!
The theme for this year's Haunted House is Asylum. We felt like Zombies was really good last year, but we could do better with Crazy. My favorite part about this haunted house is the fact that it's a free-roam haunted house. So it's not like a set path that follow haunted house. Like, normally you'll walk in and they say, go this way, make this left, make this right, here's a jump scare, etc., etc. And this year, it's your decision. You go wherever you want, and you get whatever pace you want. And I think it's going to be a lot of fun. Come see the haunted house October 29th and 30th. It'll be a lot of fun. You'll get scared. You'll definitely get scared.
Your favorite foods might be in the building at lunch because we'll be having our first food fair today. There'll be things like fried rice, pizza, barbecue, Chick-fil-A, and Little Caesar's Crazy Bread.
Remember, Clearbrook, Starbucks will be selling coffee Monday through Friday. It's only a dollar if you holler.
All right, this has been another episode of CBTV. We'll see you next week.
But first, have you ever heard of a ghost story?
When I was in grade school, seventh grade, I had a slumber party at my house, and there were like 10 girls at the party. One night, we were around the Ouija board, and I can't remember who was directing that night, you know, who was calling the spirits or whatever, but we were really into it, and just like, it was very tense and frightening. We were scaring each other. It was terrible. We were wondering who was listening to us, and that's what you do when playing with a Ouija board, or, you know, trying to talk to spirits. And it spelled out the name Harry. And then suddenly, the laundry door room opened. And there, I swear, was the ghost of Harry Houdini. And he was like shiny. You know, we could see chains. I swear more than one of us saw him. And, you know, Harry Houdini is too. Back then, he was a scary character, but magical and scary at the same time. I mean, I'm sweating right now just thinking about it. It was so scary. So that was my scariest moment with the paranormal.